This is Shadowify 2, a plugin for creating more realistic shadows and blur in Adobe Photoshop. Actually, this is just the entry panel, giving you quick access to 6 individual panels, each one dedicated to one specific use case. So let's start with the first one, crop shadows. Now you might be wondering why you even need a plugin for this, since Photoshop already has this inbuilt drop shadow effect. But as I increase the distance here, you can see it just looks like the layer is floating. In comparison, this is how it looks like with the plugin, and it gives you a smooth drop shadow effect right away. You can then play around with the settings here, like the angle or distance, and the shadow gets updated immediately. Now if I turn off the blur completely, you can even see how the panel is working by blending together multiple individual drop shadows. Every panel also has this preset section on top. This allows you to save your favorite settings for later use. For example, this long blue shadow preset here gets immediately applied once I click on it. Next up, there's a panel for creating these flat shadows here, often used for icon design or illustrations. And one specific feature that I wanted to point out is the shadow direction global light option. If you turn this on, you can actually control the shadow direction of multiple shadows at once. There's also a panel specifically for cards, and cards and papers are quite unique in terms of their shadow because it gets quite complex sometimes due to their bending property. And the panel I've built for this looks like that. If I click create shadow, it starts quite basic with just a path blur effect that you can control here or turn or toggle on or off. And the core of this panel is the warp transform input. And I've built this to directly manipulate the transformation of the layer, which can give you quite unique effects here. You can even make it softer by turning on this edge blur option with additional options below this. Here are two more examples of what you can achieve with this warp input. And there's also a panel for creating front view perspective shadows, which looks like this. Once again, you can play around with all the settings like angle, distance, and so on. And if this looks a bit too hard, it might look okay for a cartoon maybe, but if you want to smoothen it out, you can toggle on this vertical blur or maybe a fade effect to smoothly fade out the shadow. There are two more panels for specific blur effects. First one called Smart Filter Blur, which lets you create a blur towards a specific direction. You can also control the end or the start or end point here with these sliders. So as you can see, it gets a bit sharper at the end. And the last panel is called Selective Blur, which gives you similar results to the previous one, but you can exclude one specific area or selection from the blur. If I now hit Apply Blur, you can see the blur gets applied outside of the box that I draw earlier. All right, thank you for watching this very quick overview of Shadowify 2. See you next time.